Picture a hunter stalking its prey. Its keen eyes constantly take in its surroundings and plot the best course to its unwitting lunch. It plans its attack based on the victim's attributes and immediate surroundings and uses these to pin its victim down. It patiently executes every move with not merely primal instinct, but wily calculation. It's done this before and has honed its approach with experience. At just the right moment, it pounces with a big leap, taking down its meal. This sounds like a scene from Tom and Jerry, or like a human hunter in the woods. But what I'm describing is not a cat, or even a mammal, or a bird, or a reptile. It's not even a vertebrate. It's a spider. And not just any spider, but a genus of jumping spider known as Portia. These spiders are so smart that they have upended how scientists look at cognition, especially in invertebrates. They're forcing us to totally rethink how we think about thinking. So these spiders are among certain invertebrate species, including octopuses and bees, changing how we see cognition. Before researchers started taking a closer look at these animals, they assumed that an animal's cognitive abilities should be roughly proportional to morphological complexity and brain size. Researchers believed that something with an exoskeleton and a brain smaller than a pinhead shouldn't be capable of the things Portia can very obviously do. We're talking about things like learning through trial and error, anticipating future events, intentional deception, and even REM-like sleep behavior, complete with eye movements and twitching limbs. The processing power required to run the animal's cognition should not fit into such itty-bitty hardware. And yet, the spiders think in uncanny ways, like learning through trial and error. Think of a cat failing to snag a mouse that escaped under a gap in the door just in the nick of time. It's really hard to fool Simba twice. Let's take a look at how their expectation-defying antics have researchers calling Portia eight-legged cats. First, a quick primer on cognition. The term broadly covers all forms of thinking and knowing. By contrast, something that's a result of sheer instinct or reflex is not generally considered a cognitive process. In rating cognition, we traditionally place primates at the top, followed by mammals, then other vertebrates. Although more recently, the intelligence of certain non-mammalian vertebrates, like crows and ravens, has thrown a wrench into this ranking. All in all, though, invertebrates have come in last place. Increasingly, though, cognition research looking at animals has been criticized for judging intelligence against human ways of thinking. Supersmart invertebrates like Portia are helping challenge this view. Salticids are a family of thousands of species of jumping spiders, and some of them display feats that invertebrates were thought to be simply incapable of. Portia species are among the most studied salticids, and scientists have learned that, in a nutshell, they are unbelievably smart. Unlike many spiders, they prefer to not build webs to catch prey. Their meal of choice is other spiders, so that kind of makes sense. Instead, Portia see prey from a distance, consider the situation carefully, and then execute their little spidey plan. Until the late 20th century, scientists thought that these spiders' behaviors were entirely hardwired, not conceptual or learned. In the 1980s, researchers began to study their uncanny abilities. And we are going to get to what they learned, but first, we're going to take a quick break.
Thanks for watching this SciShow video, and thanks to everyone for supporting SciShow even over the holidays. Our Handmade Holidays merch celebrates the humans who make complexly videos and the joy of things made by hand, not by robots. Hosts, including me, got to put their own spin on their design, and they're full of little quirks and imperfections. The lines aren't always straight, but that's how you know a real person made it. Every detail shows the care, creativity, and humanity that goes into making things that are worth making, and by purchasing one, you are directly supporting Complexly getting to make more stuff. We couldn't do all of this without you.
Spiders are known for their eight eyes, but Portia species have two large, distinctive, dare we say even cute, primary eyes on the front of their faces, giving them a sort of cat-like look. Their other six eyes are much smaller, arranged in three pairs behind the primary set, each serving its own secondary function. Their unique arrangement of eyes gives them an amazingly detailed, wide and far-out field of vision compared to even other spiders. But eyes only see. What's acceptable exceptional about these spiders is not just their visual perception, but how they think about what they see. Like planning, based on representation, which was once thought to be exclusive to vertebrates. In this context, representation isn't like repping your favorite sports team or band with a t-shirt. It's the ability to recall and consider a mental symbol for an abstract concept or a thing, even something that isn't perceivable in the immediate environment. These spiders have a thought process akin to what might happen when you see a food truck blocks away. Roughly, you would bring up the concept of a food truck and the concept of making a purchase, decide you're going to go do that, plan a path to get to the truck, pull out your wallet, order, and scarf down a taco. But the whole process is far more detailed than that. It's not an automatic see taco, put taco in belly situation. Likewise, these spiders see food from far away, think about it, and then plan to attack and chow down. For example, a 1997 study looked specifically at Portia fimbriata, an Australian species known for its especially long and complicated detours while hunting. Experimenters placed spiders on a platform in a spot where their food was visible, but with no direct linear route to get to it. They were able to chill for a moment while visually scanning the area. Then, they were able to choose and take the necessary detour around obstacles, even when they had to lose sight of the lure on their path. Subsequent experiments using more complicated setups suggest they will persist on a detour for as long as an hour, or even more, after losing sight of the target. So they have a form of object permanence, which is also unexpected in invertebrates. They can also assess risk. Some Portia species like to eat spitting spiders, but guess what spitting spiders do? Their sticky weapon can gum Portia down, allowing the prey time to attack the immobilized predator, so Portia needs to stay out of the line of fire. Studies show that when they see one of these spitting critters on its web, they think to themselves that this thing can saliva bomb me from the front, so I will have to get around the back. But when it sees a spitting spider carrying an egg sac, it thinks, ah, this one is not going to spit because its mouth is full, so I can pounce straight on. If that wasn't remarkable enough, they also seem to be able to deceive prey spiders by pretending to be harmless. Web-building spiders sense whether a prey insect or predator has invaded their web by feeling the vibration patterns through the strands. Well, Portia spiders have a trick for that too. They have practically endless combinations of abdominal and limb movements that can mimic these vibrational signals. They throw these signals out one by one in rapid succession until they hit on the pattern of something their prey favors, like a mate or insect prey. The prey spider is naturally intrigued by what they believe is a potential sexual partner or their next serving of protein, and sends favorable vibrations in return. Portia recognizes the meaning of other spiders' vibration patterns and doesn't make its move until the prey seems thoroughly deceived. They're using trial and error to get and keep their prey's guard down until it's too late. All these antics make Portia a useful model for reevaluating and testing our hypothesis about cognition and how it arises across species. Their abilities demonstrate the flaws in the view that human intelligence is the only benchmark by which to evaluate other species. The traditional anthropocentric or human-centered view is that abilities like language, planning, and holding abstract concepts in our heads evolved together, clustering in humans as the pinnacle of cognition. The updated biocentric view assigns equal intrinsic value to all life forms and habitats, and sees each cognitive ability as being selected for by the environment. Portia spiders live in various diverse habitats on the African, Asian, and Australian continents, so the idea is that their cognitive prowess would have evolved to suit each of their own unique circumstances. This suggests that to some extent, myriad cognitive abilities may have evolved in varied combinations depending on species' varied needs. Rather than seeing language as a superior cognitive ability, for instance, the idea is that some species just don't need language as we know it. In other words, something like trial and error web vibrations may seem primitive compared to language, but maybe it's just different. So there you have it. Scientists have a lot more to learn about these spiders' uncanny cognitive skills. And maybe when we learn those things, we will admit that Portia spiders are intelligent in their own right. Not just smart for spiders, but just plain smart.